All right, our next talk is by Martha Maria Velez from the California Academy of Sciences. And her talk is entitled Dwarf Sperm Whale Skeleton Articulation at the Charles Darwin Foundation in the Galapagos Islands.
Hello, everyone. My name is Martha Velez, and I'm a curatorial assistant in the Ornithology and Mammalogy Department at the California Academy of Sciences in San Francisco, California. First of all, thank you for listening to my spotlight specimen presentation, and I hope all of you are doing well. Today, I'm presenting the dwarf sperm whale articulation in the Galapagos Islands. In January 2019, I helped with the assembly and reconstruction of a dwarf sperm whale Kogia sima skeleton that washed up on shore in August 2015 on Isabela Island in the Galapagos. Even though the distribution of this species is around the world, this was the first specimen that was collected in the Galapagos, and it was very important to have this record visible to the community of the Galapagos Islands. Godfrey Merlin, a naturalist and a resident from Santa Cruz Island, was the person who collected and completed the entire cleaning process of the bones. In the first picture to your left, you can see him here wearing a blue t-shirt next to his wife and the team members from the academy. The bones were in perfect condition and only a few phalange pieces were missing. The Charles Darwin Foundation agreed with Godfrey to display the specimen in the exhibition hall at the Charles Darwin Foundation in Santa Cruz Island, and they asked the academy for help in the articulation process. I was part of the academy team that traveled to the Galapagos to assemble the skeleton in collaboration with the Charles Darwin Foundation. Our team, consisting of Jack Dumbacher, curator of the Ornithology and Mammalogy Department, Mo Flannery, Senior Collection Manager, and myself. We also had the expertise of Lee Post, who is called the Bone Man from Alaska. He has helped the Academy with articulation of some specimens displayed at the museum, and with his expertise and knowledge, he was the key person in the assembling of this specimen. So the Academy, along with the staff from the Charles Darwin Foundation, especially with Gustavo Jimenez, we spent 2 weeks assembling the skeleton of the specimen. When we arrived, we carefully transported the skeleton on boat from one part of the island to the Charles Darwin Foundation, where we had set up an articulation lab on the main floor of the visitor center. We first laid down all the pieces of the skeleton on a table to have a visual map of how the skeleton should be. The skeleton consisted of 231 pieces plus teeth. Then we put all the parts together. We used specialized epoxies and connected materials like wires to reconstruct this rare whale specimen for public display. My days consisted of carefully drilling vertebrae, gluing bones, and casting small missing bones from epoxy clay to create the complete skeleton. In the photo in the center, you can see all the team members working in the articulation. In addition to the skeleton articulation, because our project was conducted in full public display, and as the only Spanish-speaking scientist on the team, I often conducted informative talks for the visitors of the Charles Darwin Foundation. I explained the reconstruction process to them, and I also performed demonstrations of echolocation using a tuning fork to show how whales and dolphins listen throughout vibration in the lower jaws. The articulation and echolocation demonstrations went viral in the Santa Cruz community, and every day we had people from the island coming to visit the center. They were amazed and happy to see the specimen that was collected in one of the islands and being built for display in the center. This project was a meaningful experience to me because it provided an opportunity to educate not only the tourists that visit the island, but inform the local community in Santa Cruz about this unique species that is threatened by overfishing, entanglements, and ingestion of plastic pollutants. The last photo shows the articulation of the skeleton completed. I was amazed by the result. It was my first articulation of a skeleton, and I loved the experience. To me, starting with a box with pieces of bones and ending with a beautiful piece of art of almost 6 foot long whale is amazing. The specimen is now on permanent exhibit at the Charles Darwin Foundation Exhibition Hall. If you ever go to the Galapagos, I recommend visiting this place. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Excellent talk,